So today we're feeling the Christmas spirit. So we're going to the Christmas market and we're going to have some good food, some snacks, some drinks, some... You guys are going to follow us along and we're going to show all the Danish traditional food, Christmas foods.
How beautiful is Copenhagen?
If you have never been to Copenhagen, you have to come.
Is the Christmas time or the summertime?
Summer. Both.
For me,
definitely
it's summer.
Both. But look at this, like how beautiful is it? This is the Royal Academy, like for theater and ballet and stuff like that. Right there.
We just went
to see the Nutcracker, which was cute. And this is like the oldest mall, shopping mall kind of in Copenhagen.
Yeah. Now let's try some food. We have to try everything now.
Okay,
let's try some food.
Good?
That's very good.
What's your favorite Christmas snack?
Night?
Snacks?
I'm not that big a Christmas guy, I must say, but it has to be æbleskiver sandwich,
which is like it's a Danish.
Yeah, which is like a sandwich with pork and just good.
Duck, you like duck?
I don't know. Yeah, duck must be my favorite. Not duck. Duck must be.
Duck.
And then I love hot chocolate.
Oh, me as well. I love.
And then gløgg is like I think it's Danish. It's like a Danish cocktail, which is warm and tastes like Christmas.
Wine.
Yeah.
It's boiling hot red wine with rum.
With whiskey, right?
Whiskey or rum.
Yeah. Or vodka.
Sounds crazy.
Out of 10.
It's so hot. I recently have come to like this. I hated it like even 2 years ago.
Yeah?
Because it's very dull too, kind of. Like,
yeah, I love it.
Yeah.
I love it because it's the only warm cocktail you can get. I don't know why it doesn't exist with more warm cocktail.
Yeah.
I think also just like maybe in the summertime, like a really cold day. Denmark can be like really cold in the summertime. It could be nice with a warm drink, but it doesn't really exist.
But it's very Christmassy, and that's why the only reason I love it is I love Christmas.
It's like a classic hot dog. I don't think it's like this in other countries, right? It's freaking good with all that.
Is it good?
So good. Like this, the pickles and the onions and all that just save the whole thing. could put a bad sausage in and then this on top and it would be 10 out of 10.
Thank you.
Okay. So we got the salmon with potatoes, some honey mustard thing, and tzatziki kind of thing. I don't know. How does it taste? What do you think? This place is. There's always line at this place. This is the first time we tried. The burger with æbleskiver, it's called the pig.
Pork.
And pork.
Pickles, some red cabbage.
Yeah. And some mayo, I guess.
Some mayo. It's a very.
I actually never eat pig. I hate pig, actually. Like meat. The meat pig. I love pigs. But I think for this time of year, I like it in my like Christmas sandwich. You gotta have this once a year. But like really fatty, but with like a lot of sour at the same time. It's fire.
What would you rate it out of 10?
I would say maybe this is the best. then the salmon is number two, and then the hot dog is number three. Mm-hmm. But everything is like 8+ out of 10. Good. It's like that's very good. Even better than the big crabs.
Mm, I would say so.
It's
very
more
fluffy.
Softer in the middle, which is like the best part of the pancake, I would say. The hot chocolate to finalize it all. Yeah.
The cherry on the top.
Yes.
It's quite good, but it's a bit cold.
It's a bit too cold.
Oh? Yeah.
Mm.
Cream on your nose. I'm gonna go home and maybe watch a movie. Or The Office.
Yeah. What's your favorite
show?
Like show? Yeah.
What's my favorite show? Oh my god, I have so many. I feel like I've never been into like such comedy series.
No.
But then Matt showed me The Office, and
The Office
love
is like
it. It's so funny.
It's the best.
I love that at the moment. Otherwise, I love series in general.
Yeah.
I love good
TV
series.
Shows.
Yeah, TV shows. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. But I watch more TV shows than movies.
Yeah, I have always watched.
But what's your guys' favorite TV show?
Let us know. Yeah. Let us know if we need to start.
Yeah, we want
new.
To have some new stuff. Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, let's go home.
But have a good Christmas.
Okay, guys. So today we're gonna start off the day with some breakfast. We got 5 eggs, 7 egg whites, 2 avocados. So we're gonna have the protein, of course. Then afterwards, Guan is coming. He's coming to pick up a belt, my Chrome Hearts belt that I'm gonna sell at his consignment store. So go check that out, Marked. It's called Marked. It's the best consignment store. I always sell all my things there. So this is the introduction of the winter outfits. We got Guan in the mix. And we're just here to represent some fits. And the first fit we're gonna do together.
Yeah.
So first off, I'm gonna start with the jacket. I got the mountain jacket from Rigones from the fall winter 20. And it's like a kind of a dark gray brownish. It's really sick and it's like perfect for my old black outfits. And yeah, just love this.
Right.
They only made it in this season, so it's kind of, I think it's gonna be really rare at some point.
At some point, yeah, for sure.
This is the women version, which is a lot more crop. The men's version is like a long jacket.
I have a men's one for sale, and it's like a lot longer than this one.
But it's also sick, the men's.
It is.
I feel like the women is the go-to for me. I love the crop look.
Yeah, it has to be cropped.
For sure. Right. What do you got of the jackets?
I mean, I'm gonna...
You're gonna
switch
it up?
Yeah, look at that. It's the Rick Owens Montclair collab. Tanoka jacket. Mm-hmm. There you go, I almost forgot the name. It has like these so super cool details. Like, looks like a spider web almost. Some people think it's the Spider-Man collab Montclair sometimes. And like, what the fuck? Oh, you don't know anything?
Does that exist?
Yeah, it's pretty sick actually. But it's not like this. It's just... I believe the Spider-Man one is like it's like more glossy, like shiny with the material, and then it's not like this at all.
Okay, so for my pants, I got the Forgotten Garments pants. These are really nice in the wintertime because they're warm because of the leather. These are actually made with furniture leather, kind of for like sofas and stuff like that. So they're so thick, but the quality is fucking sick.
Damn.
Yeah.
I guess it's my turn to show the pants.
Yes.
Got leather pants as well. These are from Celine. They're, the model is like it's called the Dylan Flares. And they made a pair in like a union, wash, and black, I think, as well. and velvet, actually, if I remember right.
Got my, let's do the t-shirt first. Got my vintage Slipknot tee.
Inside out, yeah. Maybe.
Inside out, right now. Always wear it inside out, actually. And I just like love the distressing. And it's kind of like, a, in a way, like blue fading to it. And you can see the print, even if it's upside inside out. No back print though, but super clean piece. I got the Yeezy Gap hoodie. This is like my everyday. I've shown these like 100 times, so I'm not gonna go over this. But just love the silhouette, cropped and really thick, double layered. Haven't washed it, it's dirty as fuck. Embarrassing, but whatever.
It's vintage, vintage vibes.
Vintage vibes.
I remember the first time I saw you in this was like on the way back from like Davide's birthday or something. Yeah. You remember?
Yeah.
On
yeah.
like the metro, yeah. for, one of the only times you've ever taken the metro. yeah, and I asked, where is this from? And yeah, it's easy.
Yeah, back. So it is called the perfect hoodie.
Yeah.
And in my head, it is the perfect hoodie. The fit is fucking good.
Yeah, esoteric sweater from, I believe it's from their very first collection, I think. Yeah, it has a super cool print. Yeah, it's really, really cool.
I got my Air Max Comme des Garçons 95. These are super sick, especially with the leather print. Stacks nice with the shoes, and yeah, has a like distressing, as you can see. I think these are the best 95. I don't wear that much sneakers at the moment, but these are one of them.
I've got the Rick
all rigged out.
Yeah, almost, mm-hmm. almost. But yeah, Rick Owens Stroh Vans. I mean, in the velvet or suede. Yeah, the suede.
Yeah, they're really pushing these Stroh shoes yeah. now. They got them like in
so many colors. Yeah, they restock
so many materials as well.
Yeah, they restock, so now the value is not that high as well. I've seen a lot of people selling like leather pairs for like.
It's not that rich to do that.
No, it's not. It's quite commercial, right?
Yeah,
yeah.
All right, for the accessories, I got the Rick hood balaclava thing. It's nice, especially when you have. No hoodie, this time I have, so I have double hood, but anyways, it's also good for like a scarf, keeps you warm. I love this. And
really cool.
I got the bag, I got a Balenciaga city bag. I love this because it has no knits, so it's much more discreet and versatile. No studs, so it's much more versatile and discreet, so you can just like wear it and have a laptop in it or sweater or whatever. For my next fit, it's kind of like a military combat kind of fit. So we got the German military t-shirt with a cutoff and just for layering, and we got the crew neck, like destroyed crew neck. I love this, but it's so soft, so every time I take it on, just like I destroy it, so I have to be very careful with this. Then I have the Balenciaga. I think this is the spring summer 20, right? These are like the best, I would say.
Cargo
jeans. And then I got the big guy here, the chrome hearts puffer. This is so sick. It's like the best puffer to ever exist, that I would say. The red Alpine Stars beanie. And to match with that, I got the Prada slug bag. I love like an all black fit, and then you have like the red tones. I love that, like give a bit of a spark in the fit. Then to top it off, we got the combat strike boots from Balenciaga. So it's kind of like a military inspired outfit, I would say.
I'm gonna show you my first outfit. So it's kind of like a casual, but not so casual, outfit. So I have this super long trench coat.
Oh shit.
Super long trench coat. It's from Arctic Women's. I wear these Birkenstocks, but they aren't your ordinary pair. It's the Chrome Hearts Birkenstocks. They have the silverware on like the like a buckle here and then a cross over here as well.
These are crazy. All the time when I see you, you wear these.
Yeah, these are my everyday
beaters.
Yeah, and then I got this Acne Studio scarf. Can't go wrong with scarves. Yeah, especially in weather like this. If you don't have a scarf, it's super cold. But once you have a scarf on, you can feel, you know, feel a little bit warmer the neck. I feel like that's where it gets most exposed to with the wind. So, yeah, scarf to complement the jacket. I got this vintage tee that from Aerosmith. I bought it from my own store. So I just tried it on and I was like, okay, let me pull the trigger on this.
That's
piece.
So sick.
Yeah, it's
so also the quality is so soft.
Like, it's so soft. Yeah, it's so soft and the colors are so good. And then I thought like, okay, this would go perfect with these jeans that I have from Esoteric. And if you guys don't know about Esoteric, it's a brand from China. I work with them personally. They do super sick stuff and their prices are really good as well. And yeah, they do some unique things you don't really see anywhere else. They've got this like super sick key detail. I think these are from last year's or 2 years ago's collection. And then super nice detail on these is that in the back, you know how these are super long? They put the hem at the bottom like up so that they don't drag as much as you would like on a pair of normal.
This is like the outcome of my Balenciaga for like 2 years of walk.
Right. Yeah. They just made it for you, so...
That's perfect.
Yeah, it's perfect. Okay, guys, it's time for the second outfit. It's more like a military, modern-day, fuckboy kind of outfit. But let's start with the jacket. It's Forgotten Garments. I don't know, you might have heard about it before, but... it's a nice, really nice jacket, made from vintage German military bags. The leather details are super sick as well. Zippers, and the zippers, like the quality is so good. And then the padding is also super cool. And then next up, we have the sweater. And this is the, from not too long ago, the Supreme x Yoji Yamamoto collab.
Wow, that is sick.
Yeah, it's with the, it's kind of like a Tekken tribute. It's like around the same time they announced like
an 8. Perfect for you.
Yeah, I think, yeah. So, it's King from Tekken. And I think, I don't remember which Tekken all these are based from. Tekken 2 or something? It's one of the older Tekkens, and then it says the greatest in Japanese, Saikyo, or it's like all in Chinese. Super cool. And it's kind of like a Christmas-ish sweater.
Yeah. Mm.
Super cozy. Next up, we have a pair of like leather patch double knees from Esoteric as well. Super cool. And then have like this round shape. Then goes in the back as well, which is something I hadn't really seen.
Oh, that's sick.
Yeah. And it says
the leather quality looks insane.
Yeah, it's great. I mean, it's a...
What is it? Is it lamp?
I don't quite remember, but there's also like a suede in the lining up here. It's hard, kind of hard to see, but super comfy, super soft at least. For the accessory, I have this capital scarf. Wow. I actually bought it in Japan. At their HQ.
That's
super
cool.
Yeah, I've never seen this pattern at least.
No.
So when I saw it in Japan, I was like, okay, I have to get it.
Yeah.
I have to grab it. And then the colors like match super well with the military colors of the jacket and the leather and the sweater, of course. So I'm gonna wear it as kind of like a balaclava for this outfit. Yeah. Are these combat ranger boots from Celine? I believe it's one of the first pairs that made like 4-1-19 or SS 4-1-20 or something like that. Super cool pair of combat boots. You can wear them for like casual outfits as well. You can have like wide kind of pants and then wide pants over them that are like kind of cropped, and then you can have like a shirt on.
Sick.
Kind of like
Celine
style.
It's from the Eddie era.
Yeah, it's Eddie. So it's it is men's as well. So
sick.
But I would say the quality is pretty fucking ass.
Yeah, it's
look at this.
Course.
After the first wear, and then like I was trying to pull it up, and then it just cracked off. I was like, there's no way.
So for my next fit, got a bit more of a takey fit. I got my Arc'teryx jacket with me, which is like a shell jacket. Super nice for the winter. It keeps me warm and keeps wind off and snow off. And underneath, it's not that warm, so you gotta have something underneath. So I got my other Arc'teryx. and this is super warm and super nice. For my jeans, I got the large baggy Balenciaga jeans. These are so freaking huge.
bought them in Paris. These are size extra small.
Mm.
So, I mean, I needed the extra extra small, but those are really hard to find.
I love the fading and the fit. It's
yeah, but super huge. Also, just in the waist, I need a belt with these. I don't know what they thought about because this is a unisex fit. So,
yeah.
Girls would be swimming those.
Yeah, but I think, I guess it's supposed to be like sitting here, kind of like saggy, a bit.
True.
It looked high waist.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, and like just drag all the way. That would be really demo to do. Like a Batman kind of vibe. Got my Ozzy Osbourne vintage tee. This is on its last days. Like every time I wash it, it just gets more and more destroyed. In the neck, but I love the detail, this dressing and the back print, super clean. I got the Rigones balaclava. I mean, this you can like use in three different ways.
I use it sometimes like this, like just like a elf hat kind
of.
Elf,
yeah.
Yeah.
Durag.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
Christmas.
And then sometimes I wear like a
kind of like a balaclava.
Like this, and then sometimes like this, so I just like
bend like a normal beanie,
yeah, like a beanie, just so it's like it has so much purpose, like 3-in-1 for the bag. I got this huge ass Rigowens tote bag, which I got with my Rigowens Boso, so I guess, yeah, some huge ass boots for winter is always good and keeps you warm. So that's my fit. All right, to start with, I'm gonna show off the jacket. It's the Prada bomber. You all know this, so clean. I think Raf did a really good job with this. Like the perfect silhouette, but I mean, bomber is always a winner. Got the small triangle Prada logo here as a pocket, really nice details. We got the Uniqlo tank top. A lot of you guys have been asking about this, but this is like, I think a $10 tank top. It's like, it's the best. It has this small ribbing in it. These are amazing. I mean,
it's the one you're wearing as well.
I wear these every day. Actually, I got this. This is from Japan, though. These are more cropped than the European versions.
Are they?
I love
mm-hmm.
them.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, the ones I buy here is like this.
I hate
yeah.
her too.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So go buy them in Japan. So for my hoodie, I got the. This is actually Fear of God, fork actually,
yeah.
F-O-G, yeah.
Yeah,
fork. But this is the first line. A lot of you have been asking about this. It's actually just like, yeah. I got, actually these are kind of for skiing, but I love these with the, just to have underneath on a snowy day or a rainy day. You got the logo there and like the pocket placement is really sick. You got the zip all the way. You can kind of use these to make them wider at the bottom, which I like to stagger over the shoes. So, yeah. For the shoes, got the Yeezy 950.
Classics.
Yeah, which is like really good with the pants, I feel like. We got the whole winter time to ski kind of vibe.
So nice.
Yeah, these are so sick. This is like a hit now, the cost bag. Everyone asks me where is this bag from. They think it's Bottega all the time, but it's just a cost bag. The fit is so sick. And the size is good. And
good
you got
for
all
traveling.
The good for traveling, yeah. And you got all the hidden pockets here. And also on the other side, you have your passport or your wallet here. Got my Oakley beanie. It's like a vintage Oakley beanie. And then my 20% mask to put on top of it. Okay, so we're home with Tobias. Made his homemade ramen.
Yes.
We actually bought all the gear and like all the equipment, all the
everything,
like went all out. But we also love ramen, so I guess this is supposed to happen.
And this is not the first or the last time that we're gonna make
this. You already made it 2 times, right?
Yeah.
This is the second time.
Yeah.
And you just bought it. So let's see. Okay,
So today we're going to the last Christmas museum, kind of. It's not a Christmas market, but it's a place where you can, like an interior shop, but they have like a Christmas theme, so we're gonna go there. And yesterday I went with the boys and ate some ramen, and now let's get into the Christmas theme again. Definitely go to this installation. It was, yes, your first time, right?
Yes, it
was. What do you think?
It was so gorgeous. Like, yeah, everything was super beautiful and special, very unique. And yeah, it was cute because of the Christmas. Yeah. Normally it's also just a shop without all the Christmas stuff.
Yeah, yeah. So they have a Christmas installation every year. But it's like really a hidden gem.
Okay, so we got a smørrebrød, which is like world famous Danish dish, fish fillet.
It's rye bread.
Yeah, it's rye bread. And we got one with fish fillet, one with egg, roast beef, and then we did some sort of like meatball
kind of
thing.
Yeah.
But this is like super, and you eat it, yeah, often in Christmas
and Easter.
And Easter, yeah. And then we're going to Paris tomorrow for Freya's holiday. We're gonna make a vlog there, but this is the end of this vlog. So please go subscribe and like. That means a lot. So, and then, yes, I have to show this. The coconut water. This is like, this is what I drink instead of water. It's so freaking good. Fountain of youth. The coconut boys. So good. Anyways, see you.